Suicide has become a very big problem in the United States. Right now, trends are increasing, not decreasing. We've seen really steep increases in suicide, especially among women and young children of color in the last decade or so. One of the problems with traditional approaches to suicide prevention is that we have waited until someone is in significant distress or has attempted suicide. If one has heart disease, you don't wait until they have a first heart attack to intervene. We can identify heart attack risk a decade or two beforehand, and what we try to do is prevent that by changing lifestyle. Turns out that suicide prevention is similar to that. We can identify risk 10, 20 years beforehand, and that is the time to intervene. We need to teach children to be able to downregulate their own negative emotion at a point before these negative emotions become overwhelming. The way we do that here at Notre Dame is to use technological interventions, including phone apps, so we're in contact with these children and adolescents on a daily basis, have them learn to report to us how they're feeling. We're matching them with a peer who is also having difficulties in the hopes that we reduce social isolation. That's an enormous risk factor for suicide. We're also using transcutaneous vagus nerve stimulation. We use a device. It includes earbuds. It can deliver music, but it also delivers a low amplitude alternating electric current. And that current is taken up by the brain, and it increases neural activity in brain regions that are associated with emotion dysregulation. There are a number of reasons why this work needs to be done at Notre Dame. One of the most important reasons is that services haven't been available in the South Bend community. Many people in the community, especially people in poor neighborhoods, are underserved, and risk is highest in poor urban neighborhoods and poor rural communities. By locating ourselves in the community, they're going to be much more willing to engage with us. It's also very consistent with the Catholic mission of Notre Dame to engage in outreach to families, to people in distress, to poor communities, and to improve quality of life for those communities. Suicide is also a dignity of life issue. We want to elevate the dignity of human life. As many people have been touched by suicide who have been touched by cancer, at least that's what national data show. When you see the extent of pain people are in, including family members, other survivors, it's hard not to want to do something about that. The field is ever evolving. The advances that have occurred in the last 10 years are remarkable. And as the field progresses, there are things that we can't foresee that we'll know in 10 years that we don't know now. And that's exciting. That keeps me coming to work every day.